And now, the first shark arrives. A 15-foot female. It's a good sign.
Woohoo!
Now, it's time to deploy the SEAL decoy and set about capturing New Zealand's second breach.
Decoy's moving perfectly, creating a lot of turbulence at the surface.
The turbulence, plus the size, shape, and color of the decoy, are all cues that might trigger a shark to attack. But in nature, there are no guarantees.
Coming here to New Zealand brought us new hope, and we're thinking maybe this is the new frontier for air jaws. But towing, day one. Day two, day three, day four, day five. We tried over and over again, and the sharks just weren't interested in the decoy. Just weren't interested.
But there is still hope for Andy to capture a breach here.
This is crazy. This is pretty crazy.
A legendary shark whisperer filmmaker has arrived in New Zealand. Jeff Kerr was the first to film flying sharks off South Africa 23 years ago.
There's no one on the planet who's captured more breaches in more locations with more success than Jeff.
Looks good. Andy, check it out.
This thing is a work of art.
For SEAL decoys, that's about as good as it gets.
First couple days, I'm towing with these really janky decoys. Their fins are taped up with electrical tape, zip ties. I'm not getting any success at all, and I'm actually thinking the decoys are pretty bad. And if I'm a white shark, I have amazing vision, I'm incredibly skilled, I've been around for millions of years, decoys matter. Did you make this?
I could never make something this cool, but I have a visual effects guy up in Auckland who made it and sent him down for us to use.
Do you think it's gonna help us get the breach?
Well, I was thinking in this clear water down here in New Zealand, the sharks can easily spot a fake. So the more realistic the decoy, the better off we are and the better chance we have of getting a breach.
100%.
This is real good towing weather.
Good luck, buddy. Don't let us down.
鲨鱼周，8月7日星期一起就在 Discovery 频道。